Well, welcome Airport Design Challengers. We're excited to have you here this week. It's been another exciting week. Today we're going to compare some of the markings and lights on a real airport. But first, let's take a look at some of the things you've created. And I'm here with my good friend, Chris Ash, who's one of my work colleagues. And I asked Chris to help us out today because Chris has years and years of experience with managing airports at all levels, from being the airport manager to all kinds of things associated with that. And he is a walking, talking expert in the field. Even though that's not his current job, he's a great resource for us. Chris, tell us a little bit about one lighting on the edges of paid services. The students will be adding lights around their taxiways and their runways. So tell us about what those look like, what the colors mean, and those kind of things.
All right, well, thanks, Rob. So, certainly, color lights are important. Much like a stoplight out when you're driving a car around the city, the colors mean something to pilots. So at night, it's important to remember that if you see blue lights are really showing where the taxiway is, where that airplane taxis, where and how it gets to the terminal or to the runway. But more importantly, it's the white lights that are really important. Those lights lend the runway environment. So when you see white lights, that's where the airplane's gonna land and take off. So it's important to know as you build these airports that you have to distinguish properly between the white and the blue.
Okay, great, Chris. So the blue lights are on taxiways, and where that becomes an active runway is when it becomes white, right?
That is correct, yes,
okay.
Absolutely.
And Chris, behind us are some red blocks on the ground and some yellow stripes. Tell us what all that means.
Yeah, sure. So first, it's the red markings on the ground, those are surface painted runway hold signs. And those signs are there to help just provide a visual aid to the pilot so he knows where to stop and how to be safe close to that runway. So he pulls up, he sees those surface painted red signs with the numbers and the letter you see. In the background, we have 3-4 left. That shows him, if I stop here, I remain clear of the runway and it's safe for everybody to continue to operate. When you look at the black and the yellow lines, those lines are used for the airplane center line or the nose of the airplane, so he knows how to keep it centered in the taxiway. But more importantly in this example, it's really meant to show the pilot again where to stop to stay clear of the runway.
And as you can see, we've got a Cessna high wing Cessna landing behind us. We're in a safe place because we're on this side of that hold short marking. The other thing that I've noticed here on the runway is as the lines go sideways, the first two lines are solid and then there's kind of dashed lines in behind it. The dashed lines are on the runway side and that helps the pilot know which side they have to stop on, correct?
That's correct. So you think about, again, driving a car when you're driving on the roadways and you see a solid line down the middle of the road. It means you do not cross that solid line. It's not safe. Same thing on the airport. If I see a solid line, a double solid line in this case, I stay clear of it to remain clear of the runway. If I see the dashed line, much like on a roadway, you can actually go ahead and cross that line and continue on. So that's how a pilot knows where he stops or where he goes when exiting or entering a runway environment.
Thanks, everybody. We appreciate you being here. Hey, don't forget to turn in your sheets at the end of the week. Those check-in sheets are really important. Your weekly progress is really important. And don't forget, you have an FAA mentor assigned to your team. Have a great week, and we'll talk to you next week.